Last week, Airtable made sweeping new announcements about their AI, specifically at a conference in California. They are releasing a bunch of new features, and we're going to be diving into them in this video. So if you want to learn about what has changed in Airtable in the realm of AI, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission here to help you unlock the full potential of Airtable, and to that end, we are going to be diving into the new features about AI that they just recently released in June of 2025. But before I get into the heart of the video, I first want to invite you to follow along with me, because if you're new to Airtable, or heck, you could be using it for a long time and still need a refresher, we've put together an amazing Airtable crash course. Over 10,000 people have taken our crash course in Airtable to outstanding results. So if you want to learn the core pieces, the building blocks of how to get going in Airtable, swing on by, pick it up for free. Just sign up with your email at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. And what I'm looking at here is the new big release for app page building inside of AI. This little logo right here is going to be everywhere in Airtable now. This is Omni. Omni is the name that Airtable has given their AI assistant that is virtually available all throughout your building process in Airtable. Now, you might find yourself saying, yeah, but I don't have a premium Airtable account. I'm not going to be able to take advantage of all of these cool new AI features. I'm glad to tell you that that is no longer the case, because it was the case. Previously, before June of 2025, you had to pay extra for AI inside of Airtable, but no more. Let's swing on by their pricing page and I will show you exactly what has changed. You have to come down about halfway on the page. But if you're starting up at the top, just to kind of recalibrate here, we've got our free version of Airtable on the far left, then Teams, then Business, then of course, Enterprise Scale, okay? Now it used to be that AI was an add-on, so you had to pay an extra like $5 or $6, $7 per user. I don't remember the exact amount, but it was an add-on to the standard Airtable license. No longer. So let's scroll on back down. It's about halfway through the page that you'll find AI. So we've got three different breakdowns here, or subcategories within AI. The first one is AI fields and assistant. When I hover over, you see it says harness the power of generative AI in your workflows. And you'll see that every single plan, even the free plan right here, far left side, free plan comes with 500 credits to this. So that means everybody in Airtable now has access to at least basic AI in terms of the AI fields and assistant. This is going to allow you to access Omni and to also bring in some of those fancier things for, building out your apps and starting with AI in the first place. That really kind of takes us to the second of these two sub features, which is Co-Builder. So Co-Builder allows you to build that app with AI's help. Very cool. This has been something that was an add-on, you know, with those add-on AI credits. Now anybody can use it. And this is really, really helpful, because if you're new to Airtable, the linking of tables can be quite complicated. If you've never done database design before, you might kind of get lost in that step. AI, specifically Co-Builder, can do all of that for you. And so you're able to start with a database that might meet the vast majority of your needs. And then as you kind of level up your skills in Airtable, you can get better with it. So it's really nice that this is now available on all tiers. Now, of course, we have to highlight the number of credits. You're not getting a lot of credits on the free plan, so it's just 500, but it's enough to get you started. And that's saying something. Now, beyond that, you've got the 15,000 credits for the team plan. This is for the AI fields and assistant. You've got the 20,000 credits for business and then 25,000 at enterprise scale. So some really robust AI credits or large amounts being offered on the higher tiers. We've also got Co-Builder available for everyone, right? And then of course, the last one here is the AI admin controls. And this is allowing you to control how AI is used from the admin panel. The admin panel is only one of those key features for the business and above plans. So of course, we're not gonna see any AI controls for the admin panel if you're not on a business plan, right? But basically what Airtable has said is, hey, you've got AI at all levels of you know, of different tiers now. You've got it all. So you can do everything. The AI admin controls obviously only pertain to people who have that admin control in the first place, which is the business and enterprise scale tiers. So what does that mean? What is Omni? Well, they're saying that Omni is the expert app builder for every business. And I gotta say, the marketing around the AI feature launch from Airtable has been perhaps one of the best marketing pushes I've ever seen come from Airtable, because there's a new video popping up on YouTube, short little demos about really cool things that you can use Omni for. Things about, driving new sales or expanding your reach as a company or new business options, like all kinds of really cool things where Omni is asked on the fly to analyze the data that already lives in your Airtable account. And he just kind of like spits out some answers. So let's say try it now for Omni. I want to actually start building an app with Omni. So first we choose where that's going to go. I'll drop it into Gap Consulting. And this looks a little bit different from the previous co-builder. So what I'm a little unclear on is, are we in fact, going to be improving the co-builder experience, or is it getting kind of overtaken by Omni? I'm not 100% sure how that's shaking out, but this is what it's looking like right now. So let's say we just want to take one of these prompts. I'm going to build an onboarding tracker. And as you can see, it allows us to build an app to streamline employee onboarding. So we got it right here. We've also got the option to change suggestions, so we can just pop other things in here. And so this is maybe some inspiration for you if you're looking to build something cool in Airtable. And then ultimately we can edit this, we can make changes to the prompt before we send it. And we can also import spreadsheets. So this is really helpful. If you're already on spreadsheets, let AI help you get out of spreadsheets. Bring them in, import them here, but then ultimately we're gonna build it. And so this is literally my first time actually using this process. And I gotta say, this is kind of cool so far. It does have a different look and feel from the co-builder. It's bringing in some sample data. It's got employees so far. It's giving them IDs, names, all of this. Okay. So a little bit of AI assessment here in terms of, are they on track with onboarding, etc. And now it looks like it's putting in onboarding tasks, again, with some sample data. This is really interesting. I mean, it's kind of fun to watch it get built live. That's a unique, fun part that we didn't really have with the co-builder. The co-builder just kind of went into a black box, did all the stuff, and there you are. You can see that it just stood up that app in, gosh, that must have been under a minute. We've got the data layer, which is these four components. Automations, did it build us any automations? No. So no automations built. I don't know if that's because this is a very simple app or if because AI is not quite doing that when we're building an app just yet, but you can work with AI to build some of your automations for you. So very good. We've also got our interfaces here. And then ultimately, if we had any forms, we could see them here. So pretty good stuff. Okay. We can pick through once we're happy. And we've, kind of checked out the app, and if we're good with it, then we just say publish. So we can choose to publish all those interfaces and they are now live. Good stuff. We could also go back and forth with the AI, of course, and you can see now Omni's popping up and saying, hey, I can help you do your work throughout this this interface. So we could find the onboarding tasks assigned to John that are due soon. I'm actually curious what that might look like. So if we take that prompt and let Omni do the thinking, this is using the data in our Airtable database and now kind of hopefully spitting out something for us. So we can see that Omni is saying, hey, we've got these two things with due dates coming up. As of my recording, it's June 29th. So we've got a couple things due in the next couple days. And we can go back and forth here with Omni in this thread as we are analyzing. So that's pretty cool. We can also, if we pop up Omni there in the bottom right corner of the screen, we can also start a new chat if we're done with this thread. So we can hit that plus button and either ask questions or analyze questions or analysis related questions. So we could say, what are the key themes about onboarding? Now, again, we just have sample data in here, so it's not gonna be groundbreaking outputs, but I think you're getting the idea. I mean, we have the ability now to analyze the data that exists in our Airtable solutions and actually drive some meaningful outputs. So what I'm gonna do next is actually do a live demo on real data. So let's flip into a solution that I'm using to actually handle our inquiry calls at Gap Consulting. So over the last several months, we've taken many, many inquiry calls, and we can pop up our AI assistant and start asking some questions. Now you see that Omni is not available on this app, and I don't know if that's because I need to first turn this app on or in some other way enable it, because this app existed before the announcement. Maybe we need to duplicate this app. So there are some questions around getting Omni in the app, because again, you'll notice that in my bottom right corner, I did not have Omni popping up. But I do have AI Assistant up here, and you know, we can just see what's here. So we could similarly ask some of the same questions. This again is the AI Assistant, not quite the same as Omni. So we can still use this though. And again, Airtable has opened this up so that we have so many different possibilities now with what we can do inside of Airtable, because they've granted those AI credits to everyone. So ultimately, what's the end game here? I mean, obviously we're using Airtable more. We're leaning into it more and more because there are so many use cases with AI to streamline our work. And the fact that we now don't have to get out of the Airtable environment, but we can stay right in our data, this is huge. So we've got the new features of field agents that are allowing us to analyze the data in real time on our database. We can talk to Omni, we can build databases with CoBuilder and Omni. So there are so many new potential options for us without requiring you to pay extra. So give it a try, implement the new AI tools in your Airtable, and hit me up with some comments, questions, or those things that you think we didn't go into deep enough. Let us know so we can do another video on the topic. I hope you got a lot of value here. Of course, if we didn't get to your questions, you can always swing by our website to get more help. But most importantly, my friend, keep on building.